Anyways, oh, my name is Fox Mantle. Again, I've been Fox. I also was thinking, like, what shirt should I wear for this? I'm like, oh, wait, I forgot. But, yesterday I picked up Kakarot, or Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. But because it's me, also, I didn't get the regular edition because I'm a moron, and I still have yet to play Death Stranding. I have the collector's edition of that, and I'm still confused on what the hell, why they're a baby. Again, I don't try to watch too many trailers. I see a little bit of it. I'm like, okay, that looks cool. I want it. So, it's kind of what I do. In any case, there we go. Collector's Edition Kakarot. This one I hope to play soon. I have to actually beat Kingdom Hearts on critical mode right now because Remind's about to come out in a few days, so... And also, I should say, I am going to, we're actually going to record today, so I'll probably see the same shirt, the next episode of Epithet Erased. But in any case, let's go ahead and get this out of the way. I should have brought my knife. Got it. Well, it's not a knife, but, you know, close enough. All right. Careful. 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 Okay, good. Remember, kids, always have a blade around. All right, so let's go ahead and pop this open. But yeah, this one, I can't remember how much it was. All right, let's see here. All right. I don't know if I like or don't like. I say I like it. I like that they don't put the game inside the casing steelbook anymore because there's a lot of games that have fallen out. So yeah, here's the game. Relive Dragon Ball Z Saga. Relive the Dragon Ball Z Saga from arrival of Raditz, the final battle against Buu. Play as several Z warriors in action RPG adventure. Enjoy lots of activities, mini-games, side quests, and train for intense boss fights. Also has a picture of Goku playing baseball. Not sure if you can see that. Alright, I doubt the entire... Okay, this confused me for a minute. I doubt the entire statue is, like, already built, but let's see here. So here's this book, which it's a lot thinner than I thought it was going to be, which I believe is, holy hell, it's a family tree, I think. Is it? It's like all the characters, I guess their relationships, that. Yeah, their relationships, okay. Also, for the longest time, I thought that, Vegeta and Raditz were the same character. I literally thought they're like, so these were the different arcs. Holy Jesus Christ. I usually don't look at the art book beforehand since it usually gives away spoilers, but I've also seen all Dragon Ball Z, so that's kind of out of the way. Ooh, cool. Okay, these are actually, this is cool. Like, it shows the models and then it shows, like, different screenshots. This reminds me a lot of, because I have the Kingdom Hearts 2 book. Kind of reminds me a lot of that. Even though this is literally just showing the models, which the models actually look like... I'm not sure you could tell, also stopped on Trunks, which is one of my favorites. Like, it looks very much what I like the show, which I think is kind of awesome. Again, I haven't seen much about the gameplay about it. I don't know if I'll stream this game, if only because my streaming usually never works. But we'll see. Come here, you son of a... Okay, where are you? Damn you, Tay. Get back here. Okay. Remember, kids, cut away from yourself. You don't want to cut yourself like some moron. Also, my brother once cut himself trying to open up a Nerf gun. That was a while ago, though. He bled. My grandma passed out, and the ambulance went to my grandma instead of my brother. It was... Also, I wasn't there. I just know all this from secondhand, but I can talk about it like I was freaking there. I was eating chicken. I was my grandpa eating chicken at Wing Street. I want to say it was Wing Street. Oh shit! Did I just fuck up the box? God damn it! Remember, kids. Oh shit! I was like, it's not knives or blades are not a toy unless they are. There we go. All right, let's see here. I want to see how the statue looks. Sad thing is, I'm kind of running out of space to put shit. Put stuff, so probably won't be able to put this up for a while. Have to keep it in the box, but still. Holy, oh my god, it actually looks like it's all in one piece. And I'm not saying like it would be broken, but I. Oh, come on, I don't want. Come on, damn you! Son of a. Okay. Come on. There we go. There's that one. All right. Actually, how long? Who? I know the big three in the early 2000s, wasn't it? It was Dragon Ball Z. It was Dragon Ball Z, Bleach, and was it Naruto? Or was it One Piece? Because I know now the big three in Shonen Jump are Dragon Ball Z, One Piece, and I think it's still Naruto. Holy hell, alright. Oh, and I thought, well, actually, the statue's, I think, a lot smaller than I thought it was going to be. But still, it is. Careful now, dummy. Oh, okay. It is in multiple pieces, but they set it up to where, I don't know if you can see that. I don't want to take it out of this packaging, if only because I feel like I'm gonna drop some shit. Fuck it. No. I'll keep it in the bag. But nah, maybe. I'm gonna go back and forth on this, aren't I? Before I break more shit, because I actually wanna keep the box and everything intact. If only because that way I can put it away. At some point in time, I'm gonna have somewhere where I can put all the, all my statues and collectibles and stuff. You can't tell, I'm surrounded by the stuff. I'm basically drowning in it. So I really don't have a place to put this right now. But once I do, I'm gonna have a crap ton of Shonen Jump stuff. Cause I have like a couple, like literally right next to me, I have like a couple of My Hero statues. The blade there. Oh, that's. That's plastic smell. Jesus Christ. Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay. So let me see here. We got Goku and Gohan on the Nimbus. And also, I don't know if you could tell, like, his little. The Dragon Ball on his head is. One, it's a 4-star. But also, like, you see, like, it has, like, a little bit of, like, look to it. You got the giant cartoony dinosaur, which looks really awesome. Nimbus tail right here, so. Actually, let me. Shut up, you! Let me see. Right here, so you get the little Nimbus tail. That's freaking cool. Let's see. And then we also have the world itself. Well, world. Oh, that's actually fucking badass! You see, like, the lake and everything, but you actually, if you look, there's the city right there in front of the, in front of the lake. You actually see the little city. God, I want to play this game now. I'm probably gonna play. I'll probably play it later. But yeah.
Oh shit. That's why I don't want to. But no, this. This actually looks pretty cool. Actually, let me see. How does it look? I don't believe I'll need you for right now, but also I'm not entirely sure. Okay, actually, let me build this real quick. You in there, you guys in here. But, no, yeah, Dragon Ball Z, I think, is legitimately, I think, the first anime I ever watched, because, obviously, like, it was the biggest thing in the early 90s, late 90s, early 2000s, I'm sorry. Oh, that looks sick. Alright, the late 90s, early 2000s. So, obviously, like, it was... Okay, here. That's how you do it. Okay, yeah, perfect. Oh, that looks nice. That's from behind. Here. So, that's from behind. And bam! That looks amazing. I love the detail on everything. I love the detail. I love the cartooniness of it. Like, even, like, the, I guess you would say forced perspective. Like, it makes it look like that city is off, super far off in the distance and everything, looking at it. Like, that is some really good, like, done. I always love, even though I don't remember this guy's name, I love this guy's art. I love this guy's art, and it's always fun when looking at stuff like, I'm gonna start putting it back. When I, like, watch something like, when Cartoon Network was running Blue Dragon, or hell, when I even saw Blue Dragon, so I'm like, wait a minute, that's the guy who did Dragon Ball, the art's from the guy who did Dragon Ball Z, or, and I'm not gonna lie, like, I wanted to get the game literally just because of, like, hey, that art style looks like this guy, because he has a very distinct art style, which, I'll put Goku back first, or, you know what, I'll put the dinosaur guy back first. He has a very distinct art style, and I really love this art, even though I don't remember the artist's name, sadly, sorry. But I really love his art style. I love, because it always is, like, very cartoon. It's cartoony, but it has so much imagination behind some things. And not to mention, you know, Dragon Ball Z is basically what defined shonen anime for, like, it's, and honestly, it probably still is what defines shonen anime, like, but, because whether it come the super, getting super, powered up version of yourself, which, I don't think Dragon Ball Z was the first one to do, like, oh yeah, well, he gains a super stronger power of himself. No, especially because, what do you call it? Especially because, technically speaking, like, Journey to the West, Monkey, which obviously is based off of, Goku is based off of, is, I think, has a super form, or since kind of like a super form, I'm not entirely sure, but, I have to wait till Red makes another recap of that, but, yeah, like, it's, Dragon Ball Z is a really good anime that I extremely love, even though I will say, like, I love Dragon Ball Z and stuff like that. Some fights did feel like, okay, why are you taking me five episodes to get here? Can't we speed that up a little bit more? Why are we taking five episodes to get to this fight when, like, it's, I don't know. It's stuff like that, pacing, but that's more something now that I'm more, I guess, annoyed by. But even then, the anime I still love. I love the animation behind it. The imagination behind it. Did I put this in the wrong box? And I'm trying to. I did. I'm shoving the big square into the little square. Oh boy, that's not gonna be. Jesus Christ. All right, but it's an animation I love. Dragon Ball Z, especially for something like what do you call it? Again, imagination. The imagination behind it, yes, but also because it mixes so many different elements together, which, to me, is always a sign of a good storyteller, is if you can mix different things, like,
futuristic while also mixing in dinosaurs and somehow still make this world somewhat believable. Also flying monkey men. Having all that together and still somehow making it believable is, I think, is an awesome thing. It is something that if you could do that, you are kind of freaking badass. And that's exactly what this guy does. I do love the series. I love some of that. And then again, it is the thing that defined everything. Even like hell, up to this day, we're like the biggest anime, My Hero right now is like one of the biggest animes right now. That is still heavily influenced by Dragon Ball Z. With like even the newest, even though like the manga's been out for a while, what is it? I recently just saw the episode where Deku goes 100% one for all. I'm sorry, I get one for all for one mixed up, but one for all, and like you shred, you see, like yeah, it's his version of Super Saiyan, it's Green Super Saiyan. So Dragon Ball Z has a giant impact on everything. I definitely want to play this now because even like the guy at GameStop where I got this, he even said like yeah, it's. It's good. I'm like, sweet. So, but yeah, so, thank you everyone for watching. I'm gonna record Epithet, Erased, like, literally, like, right now, episode 3. So, please check out my videos, check out that reaction, and we will. See you later. This is still freaking cool. I also forgot I got this, too. Yeah.